Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I am your host, Dr. Wendy Van Dilla, naturopathic physician. In the studio today with me is my dear friend and colleague, Dr. Carla Garcia. She is a doctor of Oriental medicine and uses a very wonderful and unique imaging technique that I'd like to introduce our listening audience to. So welcome to the show, Carla.
Thank you, Wendy. It's wonderful to be here. Thank you so much for having me, and thank you for providing this information for people.
It's so important. I'm just very excited to have this information going out on the air. This is a non-invasive imaging technique, and it is one that can image pain. Many of our patients come in complaining of something hurting, something aching, something burning, some kind of pain syndrome, and most imaging techniques don't go near what's going on. So this is a very unique opportunity. So please, Dr. Garcia, tell us how this technique can image pain.
So thermography is a way to image the heat that's emitted from the body. The thought is that our bodies are thermographically symmetrical and we emit the same amount of heat from both sides. And the moment that we're not doing that, that's the first sign of disease. It can be an inflammatory process that is showing up, and so there's more heat in that area. It can be neovascularity, which actually means new blood growth, new blood vessel growth that could be feeding a tumor. It could be lymphatic congestion, which can also cause pain. It can be estrogen dominance, which will sometimes show up in the breast.
And that can be men or women.
Yes, it can be men or women.
And we've got a wonderful set of slides to illustrate some of the things that Dr. Garcia is talking about. So let's start with those slides.
Okay. The first slide that we have is actually a picture of that we call Thermoman, because it shows the heat being emitted from this person's body. And in this particular scale, and there are several scales, this is the most commonly used in our practice, white is hot and black is cold. So everything that is not him is actually black, and then the temperature range goes from white, hottest, then to red, orange, yellow, green, and then blue being the coolest. And you can see that this is pretty much a healthy symmetrical picture. It's the same colors on the left that we're seeing on the right. Our normal thermal patterns are constant and repeatable, and each of us has a thermographic signature. Our thermographic signature is unique. Pathology will cause sympathetic change, and in most instances, a change in the symmetry in the body.
And by a sympathetic change, what do you mean by that?
Oh, so the blood vessels will either close or open to allow more blood flow, or to cut off blood flow.
And that term sympathetic refers to the nervous system, the automatic nervous system. When you're relaxed and things are going well, that's the parasympathetic system making those kind of symptoms or conditions that you're feeling. And the sympathetic system is when you're afraid, when you're under attack, when you're sick.
Exactly. That's what's called into play for the fight or flight syndrome. So our eyes dilate, our heartbeat speeds up. Those are all sympathetic changes. Digital infrared thermal imaging is highly sensitive and totally non-invasive. So with each image that we see, 84,000 temperatures have been recorded. And because the human body is thermally symmetrical, we can use comparative views left to right to detect physiological dysfunction. In this particular image, we are seeing more blue on the right-hand side of the screen, which is actually the left side of this gentleman's body, and he has coronary artery disease.
So we are looking at a man facing us.
Right.
Right.
So his he actually has less blood flow to his heart. The arteries that supply his heart, the blood vessels that supply his heart, are not delivering as much blood as they should. The skin as an organ, which the skin is the largest organ, has specific regions that relate to every internal organ and structure. And although we can't image organs, we can image what's called the visceral cutaneous reflex syndrome, which means that things are reflected on our skin that are happening inside our body.
Visceral means organ. Cutaneous means skin.
Skin. Good.
And reflex is what's going on underneath can be reflected on the surface.
That's right. And then our next slide is actually...
Wait. Now, on that first slide, there was also something going on in the mouth that could be detected.
Oh, right. That is, there's extra heat on the left side of his mouth, which is actually an infection that he had in tooth number 4.
That's another added advantage of this kind of imaging, is you can pick up other stuff than what you're just coming in and focusing on.
Right, and dental issues are a big part of it. This is actually a gentleman with breast cancer. 1% of breast cancers are found in men. The survival rate is much lower for men, as most breast cancers in men are only detected in advanced stages. And as you can well imagine, it is actually difficult to image a man's breasts with mammography, because there isn't very much tissue to put between plates.
And a mammogram is an X-ray, which is different from what we're looking at. And you actually have to physically put the tissue you're looking at near the film. Whatever they're using these days.
Right, and in this particular slide of the male breast cancer, the tumor was palpable at the time of imaging. There's a well-established vascular feed, or more blood vessels feeding it. You can see that in the upper left-hand side, these blood vessels coming down to feed the tumor. In this particular gentleman, there was areas of metastasis, which means that the cancer had spread to other areas of the body and other organs. So, thermography is a wonderful way to image male breasts. It's also a wonderful way to image female breasts, of course, which we talked in your other segment, and we'll touch on again later on.
Great.
Our next slide is actually a picture of diverticulitis. And while we can...
And that's a condition in the intestinal tract.
Right.
In the small intestines, the large intestines, I'm sorry, the large intestines.
Right, and what we're seeing here is there's extra heat on the left-hand side of the screen in the lower abdominal area that tells us that there's some kind of pathological process going on here. There's something going on. What we know is that thermography is not diagnostic. We don't know that she has diverticulitis at this point. We just know that there's extra heat in this area, and it requires further screening to find out what
is causing it. That could be appendicitis
also. It could be.
It could be many different things. So this is a good screening to then evaluate further with a more specific test.
Right. And our next slide is actually a slide of varicose veins. This patient came from Arizona, actually came to Albuquerque to see us, and she had been experiencing pain in her legs. She was actually a practitioner herself, and the doctor told her that she had varicose veins, and they were not superficial. They weren't visible on the surface of her skin, and so she didn't want to have the surgery, and so she came for thermography to see if there really was something. And once she saw the image, then it was like, a picture is worth a thousand words. There was no more having to convince her that that blood flow needed to be shut off to stop the pain that was happening.
Now, I see some on the image on the right, above the knee, it looks like nodes or little pockets or something.
Right, that's actually a perforator. So the vessel has actually been perforated or opened up and caused some extra blood flow to that area.
Now, is that a pathological condition the body does, or is that something that an MD or a surgeon puts in, a perforator?
No, this is before any treatment.
Okay.
So the vein has actually perforated. It has
burst open.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
it has actually burst open, and that's probably a majority of her pain that she's experiencing.
Okay, and in an artery, we'd call that an
aneurysm.
An aneurysm. In a vein, it's called a perforator.
I think so.
Okay.
I think that's right. So our next slide is actually you'll see an extra blue spot right in the middle of her back. That's actually at the thoracic vertebrae in the T1, T2 area. It's very clear. This is a type of a pattern that we see in people who have weakened immune systems, and is specifically an autoimmune disease pattern. We see this in most every chronic fatigue patient, fibromyalgia patient, wow, lupus patient. We're not entirely sure why that pattern is there. We just know that that's pretty indicative.
So what we're looking at is the back of a woman with her hair up, right? And there's a cool spot, which is the blue spot, at the bottom of her neck, top of her shoulders.
Right.
And then that red splotch is what you're talking about.
No, we're talking about the blue.
We're talking about the blue.
The blue, the round circle, the blue circle in the middle of her back is what we
That's,
see.
Okay.
Right.
That is a pattern you typically see with a number of autoimmune disease patients.
Right. That's what we see.
Okay.
And
thank
she's
you.
Probably does have fibromyalgia, and what we're seeing there is, you know, inflammation in the neck. But you could see inflammation in the neck from whiplash. You could see inflammation in the neck from some type of injury. In this particular case, this is a fibromyalgia patient.
Okay, so there were two areas that were showing a problem.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Excellent.
And the next slide is actually just more people with that same cool pattern. So you can see in all six body images that right mid-back, up close to the base of the neck, at the nape of the neck, you'll see that there's green areas and blue areas. 100% of patients with positively diagnosed autoimmune-related conditions exhibit this local hypothermia, which means less heat, over the thoracic vertebrae at T1 and T2. These patients all suffer from CFS and fibromyalgia. The reliability of this phenomenon allows us to monitor the response to treatment and rehabilitation over periods of time, days, weeks, or months. So we can actually image this and then have the referring doctor institute a protocol and then re-image it to see if now that blue spot or that green spot has changed and the body has become more thermographically symmetrical.
This is an incredibly important point is that we are actually imaging a disease or a syndrome actually that is not well defined in the MD world, chronic
right.
fatigue and fibromyalgia. So this technique actually validates the patient's suffering and can be used to then further treatment or direct
right.
treatment.
And our next slide is actually a picture of the thyroid. It's important to realize that we can't really diagnose what's wrong with the thyroid. We just know that in this particular image, and we're looking at a neck, the front of a neck, there's hyperthermia, which is extra heat over both lobes of the thyroid, indicating thyroid dysfunction. And this brings up a point that I meant to talk about before, and that is that thyroid pathology is seen in almost 100% of all breast cancer patients.
Say that again.
So
thyroid pathology
is seen in almost all breast cancer patients. So women who have breast cancer usually have thyroid problems as well. So we do store iodide in our breasts and in our thyroid tissue, also in our prostate. So it's interesting.
Men's
prostates, that's right. It's interesting because I actually have come to believe that the benign prostatic hypertrophy that is so common in men, especially as they get older, which means that there's a decreased flow of urine and frequent night urination and the stream is small, is actually a type of goiter that is happening because they don't have enough iodine in their diet.
Wow. Oh, that's a very that's a unique way of thinking about it and an important way.
Right. And we can't image that with thermography, but it's an important point that, you know, iodine is not just thyroid, it's other organs in our body, specifically breasts and prostate.
Can this imaging be used with male?
Yes.
With male anatomy?
Well, with male anatomy, but not for male reproductive health.
Okay.
or for female reproductive health either. I mean, we're not really seeing the uterus, we're not seeing the ovaries, we're just seeing areas of congestion or inflammation in that general area. And I think one of our last slides, oh no, we have several left. This one is of TMJ, which is very difficult to diagnose.
Which is temporal mandibular joint
pain.
Which is the hinge of our jaw.
So this patient had classic symptoms and also classic thermographic findings, because you're seeing a lot of heat right close to her left ear.
So she's hurting when she's chewing.
She is. She's hurting when she's chewing and probably when she wakes up. And our next slide is actually a picture of a gentleman who has Bell's palsy. Bell's palsy is a type of stroke, actually, where the person is not having blood flow to that area of the face.
And so we're looking head on and to the side.
Right, and you can see that he has very little blood flow to the left side of his face, which is on the right side of your screen. It's
so
hard.
It's a blue.
Blue,
so
yes. Dark blue on the right side of his nose.
And symmetry is important in evaluating these pictures, right?
Right, absolutely. And you know, when we think about it, we're actually all basically thermographers, because the first thing we do when our child is sick is we run to get a thermometer. You know, your baby says he or she is sick, and you think, oh my gosh, do you have a fever? And the first thing you do is you touch his head, which mm-hmm. is a type of thermography, right? You're feeling for heat, or you run and get a thermometer to measure. And our next slide is actually a picture of carpal tunnel. So what you see is on the left-hand side of the screen, so the pair of hands that has more red in it, you'll see that there's an inflammatory process, a white and more red area right at the wrist region.
Yes, yes. Toward the middle of the screen.
Right. And then you can also see that on the right-hand side of the screen. The thumb is totally inflamed.
So the green is more of a normal pattern?
Right.
On the far side of the right.
Right.
And then the middle right with all the blue, that's the abnormal, right?
Right. That's correct. Okay. There's inflammation going on there.
Wow.
And one of the things that's important to remember is that things like Raynaud's syndrome, reflex sympathetic dystrophy, where there's less blood flow to an area, those are things that are very easily imaged with thermography, and they're not. There's some discussion and dispute as to whether it's even if it's even a pathology. You know, unless you're a patient, then of course you have the pain, and so it's there. And that's what's nice about thermography, is we're imaging pain. So what we're seeing is soft tissue injury or inflammation that isn't visible on an X-ray and that isn't visible with any other type of imaging, because you're seeing the reflex on the surface
wow.
of the skin.
So this doesn't show up on a PET scan or a CT or anything like that?
No.
So, and this is much more affordable than many of those techniques also. So this really validates a lot of patients' suffering and makes it real.
That's right. And our next slide is actually a slide of carotid asymmetry, meaning that asymmetry means it's not symmetrical. So you're seeing more heat on this gentleman's right neck. So, you know, you would want to have, there's an inflammation process there. And so you'd want to have him go back to his doctor and have that actually ultrasounded or some other form of diagnosis that would let them know that there's a function there before there's an occlusion.
So the carotid is an artery, a very important blood flow from the heart up to the head. And if that gets narrowed or blocked, that's called a stroke or death or both.
And our next slide is actually just an image of shoulder pain. So
we're looking at somebody's back, correct?
Right, we're looking at somebody's back and their arms are out to their sides. And this person was in a car accident, and they had x-rays, and they said, well, there's absolutely nothing on this x-ray, and you shouldn't be complaining of pain because there's nothing here. And you can see that there's actually a lot of inflammation in her right arm and in her right shoulder. And if you look furthest up, you can see that there's actually some white. Her neck, nape of neck, right shoulder is totally inflamed. This is very common in motor vehicle accidents. And our next slide is actually a picture of what we call oral pathology. So there's actually some kind of disease process going on in either the gums or the teeth on the left-hand side. So it's the person's right side of their mouth, but it's on the left-hand side of our screen.
That we're looking, yes.
Yeah, and you can see that there's actually some orange around her lips, down her chin, and actually coming all the way down her neck. So there's some form of infection that could contribute to disease in a lot of other areas of her body. You know, the whole thought is that, you know, our teeth are not really important organs, when in fact they each lie on a different meridian, and there's all types of diseases that can be related to the teeth.
Yes, and that point is extremely important, that our teeth have a huge impact on our health, and diseases in the teeth, in the gums, in the oral cavity affect and cause disease in other parts of the body. And this is an imaging technique that can actually show that. I love that shot that showed from the mouth going all the way down into the neck.
Right.
That's really important. And let's talk about, I mean, we're seeing a similar imaging right in top of the nose, between the eyes.
Right.
Is that normal?
Yeah, that's pretty normal in the medial orbit of the eye. A lot of times people have a lot of heat there. This is, you know, they may wear glasses there all the time, and so the glasses rest in that area, but that really isn't pathology.
Okay, so the pathology we're seeing here is the mouth area.
Right.
And going down to that red with a white center, that
right,
area
the
on the neck.
In the neck.
So oral pathology is a very important part of overall health.
Right. And our last slide is actually a picture of breast cancer. And this is what thermography is most well known for, is imaging the breasts, and is most commonly used for that. We've tried to talk today about the other things that we can see, and imaging pain. Here you can see the extra heat in the left breast. And here's the stuff that we talked about in terms of the thyroid. If you look at the neck, you can see that this person not only has extra heat in the left breast, but they also have hyperthermia, extra heat at the thyroid area. So this illustrates that connection very, very clearly.
That's a wonderful illustration of exactly that. And are we seeing both of the spots that we're seeing with the white and the red, are they both thyroid, or is there other
On the left side of the screen, which would be the right side of the neck, that's carotid artery.
Okay.
So, but the thyroid never shows up that hot.
Wow.
In a normal screening.
So she's got something going on with the carotid artery too.
Possibly.
And the thyroid. So this is a good tool for then further investigation.
Right. This is, again, you know, a picture really helps the patient to see where they need to follow through with, that they need to go back to their doctor. A lot of times, you know, people go to see their doctor, and they, if they're given any type of bad news, their hope is that it'll just go away without any further investigation or without any further treatment. If they see a thermographic picture, then that helps them to see that there really is something there. And they can come back once they've been doing some type of a treatment plan, some type of a protocol, and see the changes, the positive changes that have been made.
And even if insurance doesn't cover it, it's a very affordable test.
It is affordable. We do a lot of breast screenings, and a breast screening is $195, which is very, very reasonable. I know some people who spend that much on a pair of shoes, and they buy more than one pair of shoes a year. A half body screening, so we would look at maybe the upper half of the body and check the thyroid, the breast, the abdomen. That's $275, or we can check the legs and the abdomen. That would be $275. A full body screening, which includes the breasts, is $350. So it is really pretty reasonable.
Yes, Absolutely.
And all of our reports are, what happens is the images are taken. For a full body screening, it usually takes about an hour. And then we send those images over the internet to a group of MDs who are part of our non-profit medical board. They write the report. The report comes back to us. We keep a copy. We give a copy to the patient. And we also send a copy to the referring physician.
So that's an important part, that you're trained to evaluate, and you're working with even more experienced physicians at a nonprofit board.
Right.
To write up this report that comes to the patient and their doctor.
Right. And a lot of times people want to know a little bit more. We do have another type of thermography that we don't use all the time. It's called computerized regulation thermography, and that's actually taking images before and after a cooling period to see if the body's regulating properly.
So this is different than just a straight imaging. This is actually watching how the body reacts to a stress, whether it's underreacting or overreacting.
Right, and it's not nearly as much fun because it doesn't have pretty pictures. It gives us a graph. But if we see something that's suspicious and the patient's not real sure that they want to follow through, then we do that type of thermography just to encourage them to get further diagnosis.
Well, I think that's important that these two different screening tools and imaging tools can evaluate what's going on with somebody's oral gum mouth health, which a lot of the techniques, other imaging techniques don't.
Right. And now that you mentioned oral pathology again, which is, I think we really need to make it understood that our teeth are really important. There is some very good information out there. There's several books. One is called Whole Body Dentistry. That's Whole Body Dentistry. And I think it's Michael Briner is the author.
Mark.
Then Mark Briner?
Yeah, he's a dentist in, I think, Connecticut.
And then there's also a book called Am I Dead or Do I Just Feel Like It?
Oh, my goodness.
And it's about, and it actually has, the book actually has thermographic images in it of oral pathology and how they have found disease in the body because of infections in the teeth.
That's a very important part of medicine. And we're getting close to the end of the show. I would like to encourage people to get a hold of Dr. Garcia for these incredible screening tools. They're very affordable, and we have them here. We have access to this technology, this screening technology here in New Mexico, just in Albuquerque, just down the road from Santa Fe.
Yes, and for more information, you can go to our website, which is www.thermographynm.com, or call us at 505-271-6608.
And that information is on the screen at the end of the program. This is Dr. Wendy Van Dilla, naturopathic physician. I want to thank you for viewing another show of New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I want to thank my camera operators, Harvey Morgenbesser and Dottie Hill. Thank you to George Marvin for being the director in the control room. This is Dr. Wendy Van Dilla again, thanking you for watching.